Today we will show how to find the internal force diagrams for a beam carrying a concentrated moment. After evaluating the reactions, we will start to construct the internal force diagrams. As detailed in a previous lecture, this is done by evaluating the internal forces at key critical points. Then we connect between the points to finalize the diagrams. We start from the left by working on the point just to the right of point C. We will divide the beam into two parts at that point, and we will use one of the parts to calculate the internal forces. We are free to use the left or the right part, but take care that the sign convention for the left part is opposite to that of the right part. For the current point, we will work on the left part, so we will display the sign convention of the left part for reference. Because the left part does not contain any forces, the internal forces at the considered point will be zero. Then we evaluate the internal forces at the next critical point, which will be just to the left of the support at point A. We will divide the beam into two parts at that point, and we will use the left part. We will convert the distributed load in the left part to an equivalent concentrated force, which will be 1.5 kN per meter multiplied by a length of 2 meters, giving an equivalent force of 3 kN, located 1 meter from point A. The normal force will be equal to the sum of all the horizontal forces located in the left part. And because the left part doesn't include any horizontal forces, the normal force would be zero at this point. Take caution here that although XA appears to be located in the left part, in reality, it is not. Both XA and YA belong to the right part because they both act on point A, and point A belongs to the right part. The shear force will be the sum of all the vertical forces in the left part. The left part only contains the 3 kN equivalent force, so the shear force will be negative 3 kN. We draw the value in the shear diagram and connect it to the value at point C using a straight line. The value of the moment will be calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the left part about point A. The left part only contains the 3 kN equivalent force, which is multiplied by an arm of 1 meter rotating in the negative direction to give a moment of negative 3 kN meter. The calculated value is drawn on the diagram at point A and connected to the value at point C using a parabola as shown. The use of the parabola is due to the presence of the uniform load as detailed in a previous lecture. We then evaluate the internal forces at the next critical point, which will be the point just to the right of point A. We will use the left part as before, because now the cut is at the right of point A. Point A will be located in the left part, and both XA and YA will belong to the left part. So the normal force will be negative 1.5 kN. The shear force will be the sum of two forces, the negative 3 kN equivalent force and positive YA, giving a shear value of positive 1 kN. The bending moment is calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the left part about point A. The bending moment will have the same value as the previous step, since the added forces XA and YA pass through point A and do not cause any moment about A. Next, we move to the point on the left of point D. We will work on the left part and we will display the sign convention for the left part for reference. The normal force will be negative 1.5 kN as before. The shear force will be positive 1 kN as before. The internal bending moment at this point will be the sum of all the moments in the left part about point D. The moment about point D will be the sum of the 3 kN equivalent force multiplied by an arm of 3 meters rotating in the negative direction, and YA, which is multiplied by an arm of 2 meters rotating in the positive direction. The resulting moment will be negative 1 kN meter. The force XA is not included in the equation because it passes through point D. The concentrated moment at D is not included because it doesn't belong to the left part. Point D is located in the right part, Therefore, the concentrated moment at point D will belong to the right part and not to the left part. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the point to the right of point D. We will use the left part as before, because now the cut is at the right of point D. Point D will be located in the left part, and the 4 kN concentrated moment will now belong to the left part. The normal force will be negative 1.5 kN as before. The shear force will be positive 1 kN as before. The bending moment is calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the left part about point D. The bending moment is evaluated as the sum of the 3 kN equivalent force multiplied by 3 meters arm negative by A multiplied by 2 meters arm positive and the negative concentrated moment of 4 kN meter. The resulting moment will be negative 5 kN meter. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the point to the left of point E. We will use the left part as before. Because point E is located in the right part, then the 2 concentrated loads at E will belong to the right part. So the normal force will be negative 1.5 kN as before, and the shear force will be positive 1 kN as before. The bending moment is calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the left part about point E. The bending moment will be evaluated as negative 2 kN meter as shown. Next, we evaluate the internal forces just to the right of point E. We will use the left part as before. Because point E is now located in the left part, then the 2 concentrated loads at E will belong to the left part. The normal force will be the sum of all the horizontal forces in the left part and will evaluate to zero. The shear force will be the sum of all the vertical forces in the left part and will evaluate to negative 1 kN. The bending moment will be evaluated as negative 2 kN meter as before. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the point to the left of point B. For this point, we will use the right part and we will display the sign convention for the right part for our reference. The normal force will be zero. The shear force will be negative 1 kN. The bending moment will be calculated by taking the moment of all the forces in the right part about point B. The right part has 2 forces, YB, which passes through B and doesn't cause a moment about B, and the 2 kN point load, which is multiplied by an arm of 2 meters, rotating in the negative direction, giving a moment of negative 4 kN meter. Next, we evaluate the internal forces at the point to the right of point B. We will use the right part as before. The normal force will be zero. The right part contains only 1 vertical force of 2 kN pointing downwards, so the shear force will be positive 2 kN. The bending moment will be evaluated as negative 4 kN meter as before. Finally, we evaluate the internal forces at the point to the left of point F. We will use the right part as before. The normal force will be zero. The shear force will be positive 2 kN and the bending moment will be zero. After connecting all the calculated values, the final diagrams are produced as shown.